and welcome to Henry's Storytime. So today, I'm going to be reading you a story that is very interesting, and it's all about flanimals. So flanimals are a little bit like dinosaurs, but these ones are made up, whereas dinosaurs are science. So here we go. You ready? You want to see the front cover? Bit of a weird front cover, but it's a good one. The flanimal kingdom is one of the most diverse natural phenomena in the known universe. Or the unknown universe, probably. We can't be sure. It's unknown. But we do know this about the unknown universe. Nothing. Which is something, I suppose, and something is better than nothing. Anyway, flanimals range from the sprangled humple dumplers to the ongless larbs, from spuzz gups to helm grindlers. You want to see what one looks like? Ooh. Fossil evidence shows that flanimals evolved over millions of years. From lowly splawn, which mutated in different ways, came the vast flanimal kingdom we see today. One flanimal thought that a weird thing called Grob, who lives in the sky, made all the flanimals in one day. Mental! Flanimals are different. Not just different from you, but different from each other. Some are even different from themselves. They all look different. Except the Woboid Mump, which can't look at all. And they all behave differently. Except Grundit, which never behaves. There he is, over there, not behaving. Grundit likes to use gronlets to hit the puddle flaps with. It's not trying to hurt him, it just likes the boingy sounds it makes. Actually, it does hurt it quite a bit, but that's hardly the Grundit's fault, is it? Oh wait, yes, it is. The Gernloid is trying to get away from the Munch Fuddler, who is clearly out on the fuddle. The last thing the Gernloid wants is to be fuddled. And in fact, being fuddled can be the last thing he gets, as often a severe fuddling is fatal. This Hemel Sprot typically isn't looking where it's going. I'll tell you where it's going. It's going to get chewed to death and swallowed by the Sprot Guzzler. Oh. Flanimals of the deep. All flanimal life evolved in the sea. Well, not all, obviously. Some didn't evolve at all. The ones that did, they evolved in the sea. From the simple primitive Mulgai to the mighty Molth, from Spluffs to Groy, and from Skrulls to the most intelligent creatures on the planet, the Mulon. The Mulon evolved nicely in the sea, then got out onto dry land, but didn't really like it in the end, so just evolved back a bit more and went back in the sea, really. Flanimals have conquered the land, sea, and air. The first ones to take to the air were the Blugs. Blugs are the most diverse and numerous of all flanimals. And it's a good job they live in the skies. The sky is so big. One species of Blug is the most ferocious and feared of all flanimals. The Bletchling. It's mental. Can fly, but only vertically downwards. It does not employ the traditional help of its wings. It uses gravity and stupidity. The powerful flat tail and sharp beak are perfect for diving deep into the open and hard shells of water. Unfortunately, it lives in the desert and starves to death in no time at all. There are so many species flanimals that we are discovering new ones all the time. Here are some I discovered last Thursday. The Gog Prodler. Both its name and Latin name say it all. Well, they explain the googly, bulgarasty nature and morphology of the pokey prod's stalkiness, but they don't explain the slamper by Dutchy blabber. I don't intend to either. But be warned! Stare at a thing that is essentially 2 3-fingered arms that can see what it's doing, and you are bound to get poked in the eye. The Squeeg. This total in egg McGoof muff is thought to be the missing link between prehistoric skanklets and the first dunklings. It is quality to both. Unfortunately, it only has the bad qualities of both. If they ever met, the strangulator and the flubberdunkling would gang up and teach this pathetic web-footed freak a lesson. The Puddler. The Puddler is the adult stage of the tiny flagpole. Flagpoles live in puddles and have the ability to mutate into any flanimal. As long as it's a puddler. Puddlers live in puddles too. They're exactly like flagpoles, but bigger. I really hope you enjoyed reading the Flanimals book with me, and I hope it's inspired you to even think about creating some of your own dinosaurs, thinking carefully about their special names. What sort of ideas do they conjure? Is it going to be a scary dinosaur? Is it going to be a carnivore? Is it going to be an omnivore? What sort of dinosaur will you create? So maybe you can think carefully. So bye from Henry, and thank you so much for listening to my story. I really liked reading it. Bye!